Hey you people, time for another sewing project. Check out Domo. He says talk nerdy to me.
True.
Anyway, the pattern I'm going to be using today is Simplicity 6966. This pattern is from 1975, and what it is a kimono styled top with two variations. So you either have the long kimono sleeve or you have the short sleeve. And it does have a lining with bias tape on there around the cuffs and the edges of the shirt. Nice, right? So there's a pattern on eBay, a Japanese pattern, and it was probably made in the 60s. I'm sorry, not a Japanese pattern, a kimono style pattern. I think it was made in the 60s. The pattern is $75. I said I'll figure out a way to do this, and I am certain that I got this pattern here from the thrift store for like 29 cents. Not bad. Here, it's got four pattern pieces, which makes it awesome because typically Simplicity has 1,000 pieces in each of their patterns. The fabric that I've chosen to do it in is this awesome tropical shirting fabric. Purple, green, pink. The background is like a khaki beige color. I got a bolt of this fabric, 5 yards, 5¼ yards for $1 at an estate sale. Yeah. So I'm going to be using most of the bolts. This is what is left of the 5¼. No, wait a minute. Oh, this is the this is the back part of the dress, gal. I don't know what I did with the rest of the fabric. But anyhow, so I'm gonna be doing it in that fabric. For the bias tape, I'm going to be using this dark green bias tape that I got from Joann's on clearance. I don't know why I don't... Everything that I was going to use is missing. Okay, I would just like to say it is 1 a.m. in the morning. I'm kind of slap happy, so this is a little off. So I apologize for my being extremely goofy right now. But this is the Hunter Green bias tape I'm going to be using to edge the shirt. Also, with most kimono style tops, there is a tie here. What I did for the tie is this beautiful mint green shiny satin stretch shiny satin material. I don't know when I bought that. It's been years since I bought that. Probably it was on clearance or on a good sale. I don't know what I would use it for otherwise, but it's going to be used for the tie on the top. Now actually, the ties are a little bit wider than I want, and I want there to be more ties wrapped around my waist, so I increased the tie by one extra tie, and I cut all three of them in half. So I'm actually increasing it by six, it should be two. So I'm increasing it three times so that I'll have more tie to do around the waist. Also, instead of making a top, I actually lengthened it so that it becomes a dress. So, what you'll see in the next part of this video is actually me lengthening the top into a dress. I'm going to show you how I did that, which is very simple to do seeing as how this is a Jiffy Simplicity pattern with only four pieces in it. Only two pieces needed to be lengthened, so that'll be pretty easy. I don't think that there's anything else that I need to tell you. So watch the video to see how I lengthen it. It's easy, trust me. Sometimes I just see a shirt pattern and I'm like, that would be so much better as a dress. This happened to be one of them. And then, y'all know after that, you'll see me wearing the outfit. Alright, well, stay tuned to see how to lengthen a top into a dress.
So what I'm pointing to right here is the line where you are either to shorten or elongate your garment. Most modern patterns have this printed on there somewhere. And now what I'm pointing at is the selvages. This is on a fold of fabric on that side, and on this side, that's the actual selvage. So I actually had to repress it so that I could fit it, the piece of pattern inside of the 44 inch wide fabric. Now it is very, very important that if you are using a rotary cutter, that you make sure that your blade is sharp. If it is not, you will run into the problem that I ran into doing this entire project, which was not getting clean cuts. I would probably suggest after every 5 projects, you replace your blade on your rotary cutter to keep it clean, as well as to keep it in good working order. Also, make sure that you tighten it, and also, please, please, please make sure every time you sit it down that you close your blade, because that bad boy will slice your fingers. Now, as you can see, where I cut the fabric on each side of the pattern piece, I'm stopping it right at that line where you can either shorten or lengthen your garment. It's very important that you do that if you decide that you're going to shorten or lengthen something, to stop right at that line when you're cutting. So I decided for my height, I'm going to increase this pattern piece by 30 inches, so it'll extend all the way down to the floor as a floor length gown. In order to do this though, you need to start your measurement right at that line to lengthen, and then extend it down the fabric. You don't want to start at the bottom of the pattern piece because you're not going to get the proper measurement. And then when you move your pattern piece, I moved it right to the 30 inch line across where the lengthened line is on the pattern piece. So I have a total of 30 inches increased on that piece of fabric. It's probably easier to do this with a yardstick than it is a measuring tape. I would suggest using a yardstick. Why I didn't use mine, I have no idea. Just use your yardstick. And if you don't have a rotary cutter and you're thinking about getting one, trust me, they are expensive. To replace the blades are expensive if you get quality blades. And the rotary mat, the self-healing mat, is expensive as well. But it's worth every single penny. It has changed my life. I rarely use my fabric scissors anymore. The rotary cutters that I use are both Fiskars. The small white one that I use is a titanium. The blade on that one is amazing. I'm going to have to replace the blade on the bigger one with a titanium blade as well. I think it'll do better for the projects that I do, since I use such strange fabrics for some of my projects. The self-healing mat, I believe, was probably about $50. And then I had a coupon, which I bought it at Joann's. I buy most of all of my stuff at Joann's because it's the nearest fabric store, craft store around. I got it for about $20 after coupons and stuff. So if you can get a rotary mat and a rotary cutter, please, please, please do it, because it will change your life. Now, I know that some of you use different things to hold down your pattern piece. I like to use deck of cards because they're small enough to fit into strange pieces of fabric. I'm sorry, of pattern pieces. As well as they're quick to grab and push away. Sometimes I use books on bigger pattern pieces, like on circle skirts. But for me, using deck of cards works perfectly. perfectly. The only problem I have with them is if the cards slide out of the box. Oh, and if you've never played Phase 10, go get that game. It is so much fun. So when I'm cutting on the fabric, after I've extended it the 30 inches, you just go ahead and cut it straight upward. Because you're going to continue cutting or pick up where you left off cutting at first. Now to continue cutting all the way back up to the first lengthen line, I'm just going to use this little plastic guide, which will help my rotary cutter stay straight. You can use your yardstick. If you have your yardstick out, that'll work just fine. I'm going to cut all the way back up to the first line. And this is the finished pattern piece. Nice!
So how did you guys like the dress? Yay! I got so many compliments tonight at Bible study. Not that that matters, but I'm just saying, everybody liked it. it was relatively really easy to make. The four pattern pieces were awesome. Even applying the bias tape along the entire dress edge was pretty simple to do. I would love to make this pattern again in a different fabric. There were a couple of things that I did change that I did not mention the first time around. As far as the belt, I did end up making it in the original size that it was patterned out for. When I tried to make the tubing smaller, it wouldn't pull through. The stitch actually wouldn't stay. I tried to actually serge the tie end as well, or the tubing as well. That did not help with trying to pull it or trying to turn it inside out for it to be stitched to the actual garment. So I just stuck with the original size of the tie ends or tubing, and it worked just perfect. It is really good. I used I cut four of them, so I did not increase it by three. I increased it by twice the length, so that allowed me to get more wraps around my waist. I do wish that I had increased it by a three, because it would have given me more material to work with, but it did turn out really nice. Another thing that I would have changed if I had really thought about this dress in a more haute couture type fashion, I definitely would have lined the sleeves. The inside of the fabric is not printed. It's just kind of see-through from the right side of the fabric. So I would have loved to have lined at least the sleeves with the same material as my modesty piece here, as well as the tie end for the belt. Now, this was not called for on the pattern. On the actual pattern, which I think I've put away, on the actual pattern, both ladies have small bust area. So they can get away with not having a piece to cover their cleavage or anything like that. Because my intention was wearing this to Bible study, having the cleavage covered is a must. Not that I wear my cleavage out anyway. But anyway, so I did attach this piece, and it is literally just a little triangle of fabric. It's not an entire shirt. I put a snap here, and a snap here, and a snap here. And what I'm going to do is show you the footage of how I attached this modesty piece right here to the dress.
Whenever everything feels like touchdown on a rainy day. never done.
So in all, I really like the way that this turned out. I would suggest that you go out and find some cheap fabric. If you are lengthening something for the first time, turning a shirt into a dress, or turning a skirt that is short in pattern into a longer skirt, get some cheap fabric. Get some muslin first and try it so that you're not wasting your fabric. Like I said, I bought this 5 yards for $1 for the entire bolt. So it wasn't a loss to me. And I don't think I have quite a yard left. But I have enough left that if I want to make a head wrap with it, I can do that. And maybe like a little shrug or something. But of course, I wouldn't wear it with this. But it would just be a shrug to have as part of my wardrobe. But I really did enjoy wearing this. It's really nice for the fall. It's light enough to wear it in the summertime as well. I have a full-length slip-on underneath of it. I find that helps out a lot with temperature control. If you wear a sweater like I do, I'd be in the outside in negative 30-degree weather and I'll still be sweating. Slips help a lot. So invest in a slip. And a lot of places don't sell them anymore. Go to your thrift store and get a slip. A full-length slip, not just a half slip. All right, well, that's it. You will see more sewing projects from me soon. Goodbye, Tamadachis.